And she says, what does it mean? And these are the laws that that you should put in front of Am Yisrael. Hashem told Moshe, and these also, these laws, are the laws you should put in front of Am Yisrael. So it says, if it would say these, it would mean these and not the ones before. Because it says ve'ele, and these, it's adding to what it said before. What did we just end off last week's parasha, Parashat Yitro? We ended off with Aseret HaDibrot. Just like Aseret HaDibrot was giving in Har Sinai, so too all of the mitzvot of the Torah, ve'ele Mishpatim, every detail was given in Har Sinai. A lot of times, boys come to me, tell me, Rabbi, can I go this and this place? I tell them, you can't go. It's a problem. Please, Rabbi, please. You don't understand. You have to understand. I understand you. If you need $100, tell me. I give it to you. Push me, push up. You need 500, 500. But I can't take the Torah and tell you, okay, it's okay. But no, but you don't understand, please. It's not my Torah to tell you okay. If it's not okay, it's not okay. The Torah we have, Zem Sinai. What does it mean, Zem Sinai? It's from Sinai. It means that Kadosh Baruch Hu came down in himself and he told Moshe Rabbeinu all of the details of the Torah. And he told him how a Jew is supposed to live his life. To every little detail. And that's it. So who are we now to start cutting and pasting and saying, okay, this is okay, and that's okay. Notice an exact way how to live. We all finished with, we had Obama for 8 years, and now Trump came in. Democrats, Republicans, what happens now? So now Obama, he decided to make all different laws. For 8 years, he was inventing these laws. Why? It was not the Shem Shamayim, that I can assure you. It wasn't the Shem Shamayim. It was because whatever was comfortable for him, whatever made sense to him, that's what he did. What happens now when Trump comes? So besides that he has different outlooks in life, but just to prove that Obama was wrong, and he's not going to do what Obama did, he just changes everything around. So now, so what happened? For 8 years, that was the emet. And now Trump, this is the emet. No, it's all shekel, it's all a joke. It's all personal feelings of what a person wants to have, he wants to run his country. Has nothing to do with what is the truth. And that's why if you look through all of the rules and regulations of most countries, you'll find contradictions on top of contradictions in all of the laws, because how are they made? They're all man-made. And the first guy that thought of one idea, he made one law. Second guy who thought about something else, he made a different law. The third guy made a different law. And it's all built on nothing. So now when you finally come and you check all the laws, you see there's a lot of things that don't make sense. Only the Torah, ve'ele ha'mishpatim asher tasim lefneihem, were given in Sinai, exact. How exact was it? Histakel b'oreita u'bara alma. HaKadosh Baruch Hu looked at the Torah and then he made the world. He created the world through the Torah. Why do we have eyes? Happen to have eyes? No. Because the eyes are used for a keli, for some type of a tool to learn Torah, to watch our eyes, whatever we use our eyes for. Why do we have eyes? Because in the Torah, through the Torah, you have to have eyes. You have to have ears, you have to have a mouth. If the Torah did not need that a person should have eyes or a mouth or ears. We wouldn't have that. Maybe we have something else. Maybe we have our ears and our feet and our eyes and our stomach. I don't know. But that's how the Torah is. And through the Torah, the world came to be created, and a human being was created. Why do we have parents? Huh? Because we have a mitzvah in the Torah, kibud av v'em. We could have technically been born growing on a tree. What's the difference between an orange or apple that grows on the tree or a human being? Same thing, take a seed, put it in the floor, tree grows, and here you have boys, girls growing on the tree. Great, you come after 9 months, whatever it is, you pick the guy off the tree. Hazaku baruch. Why does the mother have to suffer? Has it been in the stomach for 9 months? Why? Because this Torah tells us, kibud avaim, and you have mitzvah of kibud avaim, and the way to do it is that a mother gives birth and she brings up the child. Everything is built through the Torah, opposite of what we think sometimes, that we're doing someone a favor by being Shomei Torah Mitzvot. The opposite, we're only doing ourselves a favor. I'll give you a mashal. They build a big office building, very beautiful office building, right? With offices and everything you needed to really have the perfect office building. Came a time, a few years later, they were missing a hospital. They needed to build a hospital in exactly that same place. So they didn't have a choice, and they took the office building and they made it into a hospital. So they're breaking walls, they're fixing things, they're making a lot of changes. But bottom line, as much as they try to change around this office building, it was never a perfect hospital. Why? Because it was built as an office building. A hospital, you have to build as a hospital. There's different types of things that you need, different rooms, different heights of ceilings, different things that are needed. So they tried as much as possible to turn it into a hospital, but it was never really 100%. So too goes with our lives and observing the Torah. Our lives were created perfectly in a way to keep the Torah. And the best way to live the life is through the Torah. Why? Because Hashem that created the Torah created us through the Torah and created the world to work through the Torah. And believe it or not, that's why we have Ramach Evanim, Meshaseh Gidim, we have 248 limbs and 365 sinews. Keneged, every mitzvah ta'aseh, mitzvah lo ta'aseh, we have the Torah. Everything is built perfectly, exactly according to the Torah. So now when we come and we want to change the Torah, it's like saying, you know, can I make a little cut over here? Is it okay, Rabbi? Let me make a little cut over here. Is it okay if I cut off my arm? Is it okay if I cut off my leg? It's not a big deal. It's only a leg. It's not. This is more or less what we're saying. Why? Because Torah was created perfectly for the human being to live in this world. So we have to remember, this is not our Torah to play around with. If HaKadosh Baruch Hu himself would come down and we would see him, which he did, and we did see all our neshama tzur, we won't start arguing with God and tell him, you know, maybe we could make a few changes in the Torah, maybe we could take out this pasuk, take out that. We understand that this is Melech HaOlam, the King of the world, that created the world, and he gave us the Torah. So our job, if we want to have the best life properly, as possible, we want to live in a healthy way, we want to have long life, Eleha Mishpatim, to remember, these Mishpatim, these laws are not man-made, they're made by God, and the better and the more exact we keep all of these laws and the Torah, the better lives, Be'ezat Hashem, we'll have. Have a good day.